Welcome back to the Value Education and Spirituality series. We are discussing from the Mahabharata. Now, Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana are the central negative characters, and they are negative not just because of some stereotyping but because of their own choices and their character. Now if we look at the Mahabharata, the Pandavas are virtuous, but there are shades even among them. Bhima often tends to be quite strong and violent, sometimes brutally so, although he's a righteous person. And then similarly among the Kauravas also, Duryodhana is evil. Dhritarashtra is not actively evil, but he is passive, condoning evil. Now Karna is on a spectrum where he has definitely much more virtues than Duryodhana and other Kauravas, but somehow he gets trapped. And from Karna's life we will look at several lessons. One of the most important ones is how a virtuous person gets spoiled by bad association. So now let's first start by looking at Karna as an example of a person who was a person who did wrongs. Karna comes out worst in the Asat Sabha, in the assembly wherein Draupadi was dishonored. So now let's go, we will discuss the details of the gambling match later, and we will discuss about the dangers of gambling at that time. But let's focus on this one point right now, that it was Karna who suggested that Draupadi be brought into the assembly and be dishonored, be disrobed and dishonored. Now this is a ghastly suggestion for a Kshatriya who is meant to be actually a protector of people. Kshatrayate iti Kshatriya. So Trayate is to protect, Kshata is hurt. So one who is meant to protect people from hurt, for such a person to actually suggest and plan and later on justify the dishonoring of a woman of a royal family whom he is meant to protect, being related to that same royal family, it was unspeakably barbaric for him to do that. So when Karna made that suggestion, the whole assembly shuddered, because it was such an unspeakable suggestion. What to speak of actually being done, should not have been spoken, what to speak of being done. But then Dushasana went and grabbed Draupadi and brought her in, and all that incident we'll discuss later. Right now let's focus on Karna's role over here. So eventually when the immorality of that action started becoming obvious, Vikarna was one of the brothers of Duryodhana, one of the 100 Kauravas, who protested strongly, and he gave three reasons. He said that Yudhishthira did not gamble voluntarily, that the gambling match was against the rules because one person was taking the money and another was throwing the dice. Shakuni was throwing the dice, Duryodhana was trading the money. This is against the rules of gambling. And thirdly, Yudhishthira had gambled himself before he gambled Draupadi. So therefore, the gambling was not proper, and therefore he said the whole gambling match should be declared null and void, and the Kauravas should be given their king, Pandavas should be given their kingdom back. At that time, all the courtiers and others assembled in the assembly cheered Vikarna, and they approved him. And the tide seemed to be turning against Duryodhana and Dushasana and their vicious schemes, and it seemed that justice would reign. But at that time Karna got up and he raised his huge powerful arms and he silenced everyone, silence, silence. And he said, I have seen many improper things in this assembly, but the most improper thing I am seeing is the speech of Vikarna. And he now, that a woman was dragged into a public assembly and she was disrobed publicly, that Karna is not thinking to be wrong. He is saying that that the attempts to stop such a dishonorable thing is the most dishonorable thing he is seeing. What perversity of this is this? And then he gave his reasoning, nobody forced Yudhishthir to gamble the match, gamble, and he could have stopped at any time. And it was Yudhishthir who gambled, so it is his mistake, it is not the assembly's mistake that he gambled her after he had lost himself. So he said, let it proceed. And then again, Dushasan tried to disrobe Draupadi, and then Krishna, manifesting as an unending sari, saved her honor. But the point was, Karna again and again tried to justify it. And later on, after this whole war took place, 13 years later, when he met Bhishma, on the 10th day of the Kurukshetra war, Bhishma fell. And then Karna knew that Bhishma was going to die, and he wanted to have emotional closure before death. So he went and spoke his heart, and they had a heart-to-heart talk. And that time Karna said this earlier to Krishna also, when Krishna met him as when he had gone to Shantanu, he said that, actually, I bitterly regret the words I spoke to about Draupadi. He had called. So another thing which he said was, which was very bad, was that he said that what kind of woman has 5 husbands? Now, she's already a prostitute, and she can nothing wrong if she is disrobed, because she's already living like a prostitute. Now, a prostitute is a woman who sells her body for money. So Draupadi had done nothing like that. She had only participated in her father's Swayamvar, the Swayamvar that father had organized for her. And then the contestant who had won the match, he went with her. But circumstances are in that she had 5 husbands. All that we'll discuss later. But the point was, Draupadi had no role in going and actively soliciting more than her husband. And the morality of that arrangement, which we'll discuss later, had been ratified even by a great sage like Vyasadev. So the point is, it's an unjustified accusation, and it was an intolerable accusation for an honorable woman to be called a harlot. Vaishya is an unspeakable crime. And Karna says over here to Krishna and to Bhishma at different times that, actually, I bitterly regret the words I spoke about Draupadi. He says, it was only my desire to please Duryodhana that made me do such things. So if we look at the trajectory of Karna's character, what happens is, initially when the Duryodhana and his team, especially Shakuni and Dushasana, are planning something evil, Karna opposes that. For example, when they want to send them off to Varanavarth and burn them alive, so at that time Karna says, don't do this, you know, let us call them, have a fair fight, defeat them, and then you can take the kingdom. Shakuni says, you will not be able to defeat them, they are too strong. Karna wants to oppose him, but Duryodhana takes the side of the Shakuni, and they go ahead with the conspiracy. So in those times, in the initial conspiracy that Duryodhana hatches against the Pandavas, Karna is a reluctant participant. But slowly, by that bad association with Duryodhana, he gets spoiled. And he gets spoiled to the extent where he decides to he not only goes along with doing something dishonorable, but he himself proposes something more dishonorable also. See, there are 3 levels over here. One is, somebody else wants to do bad and we go along with it. Second is, we also actively participate in doing the wrong thing. And third is, we ourselves propose something new which is wrong, which the other person had not even proposed, and we propose that. And that is total corruption. It is actually perversity happening. So what happens is, Karna is initially a reluctant participant, then he becomes an active participant, and then he becomes not just an active participant, but he becomes an active suggester of further aggravation, expansion of schemes. And in this way, he actually he actually spoils everything over there. So, now how does this happen? That is the power of bad association. Now, the nature of the relationship of Duryodhana and Karna, we will discuss in a future session. But here the main point is, we can all see in our lives how we are affected by the people around us. Now, all of us want to feel accepted and respected in whatever social circle we belong to. And if we are in a social circle of people who are virtuous, upstanding, morally upright, then in order to be accepted and respected in that circle, we have to also become upstanding, morally upright, virtuous. And that's how the social circle can help us in our inner growth, in the building of our character. But if we are in a social circle that is against, that encourages vice, that encourages bad habits, and that cheers immorality and depravity, then in order to gain acceptance and respect in that social circle, we end up doing similar things. So for example, say when students come to college, say if they're coming to a hostel or they enter into college, then often there is ragging in the college that happens. Now, ragging is a very unfortunate and undesirable part of the campus culture today, but unfortunately it is there. And then, so when the students, at that time they will be compelled during the ragging sessions to do some things which they do not want to do, which their parents have taught are wrong, which they know themselves are harmful, but they end up doing it. So, because all the friends are smoking or drinking, they also smoke or drink. And then, afterwards they actively participate. And then they find out some more things to do which others are also not doing. And they become leaders in the pack that is going towards perversity. So, in this way, the social circle that we place ourselves in shapes our character. Sangat sanjayate kamaha. The Bhagavad Gita says in 2.62 that Sangha and our association sanjayate is born kamaha, desire. So whatever kind of association we place ourselves in, accordingly our desires will develop. And when our desires develop accordingly, then we go down or go up dependent on those desires, which are determined by our association. That's why it's vital for us to choose friends who will bring the best out of us and not friends who will bring the worst out of us. Now, Karna was in his own ways virtuous, but Duryodhana unfortunately brought the worst out of him. And the worst was that he went against his own character, his own conscience, and he suggested the disrobing of a chaste woman and the dishonoring, and not only suggested but justified it and publicly called her by a shameful name. So this is how actually bad association can bring out the worst within us, and we have to be very careful to choose our friends. And we should know that choosing our friends, essentially we are choosing our character, because we all are social creatures and we want to feel valued and accepted and respected in whatever social circle we are in, and we can't live without some level of social acceptance in whatever circle we are in. And to get that acceptance, we will conform to the expectations of that circle. So that's why what is important is to place ourselves in a social circle that brings the best out of us. Now we may say that, oh, actually everybody does nasty things. No, that's not true. Yes, there may be a majority of people who may have some bad habits, but within every group, even if you're in a college, even in a class, even in a hostel, you'll find there are at least some students who want to live a virtuous life, who know that, okay, I come here for college, I come here for studying. My parents are spending so much money so that I can have good education, and they expect me to live a upstanding life, not that I waste my time and get myself entangled in bad habits. So when we remember this, and then we seek out, there may be a small friend circle also, but that friend circle will give us a sense of belonging, a sense of acceptance and a sense of value and respect for the best that we can become. So Karna demonstrates that if we don't choose the right friends, then instead of the best coming out of us, the worst will come out of us. Thank you. Hare Krishna.